We love virtual reality, which you probably already know. Our goal is to get more people into VR, but also to feed your thirst as an experienced VR adventurer. So in this new VR series called Dive Into VR, we dive into what's out there that you might not have heard of. So purely informational for your entertainment.
Today, we are starting with probably the most powerful lightweight VR headset yet, the Pico Goblin 2. Pico has been making VR headsets for the past 3 years now, and the Goblin 2 is their third standalone headset. It is a powerful headset, but how come you don't hear much about the Goblin 2? What is it capable of compared to other 3 degrees of freedom headsets like the Oculus Go?
I'll let you know in this video, coming up.
If you haven't heard of Pico yet, then it is not because you lived under a rock. No, Pico has been more busy in the enterprise industry actually. In the West, their headsets are more widely used by businesses for development purposes. They are also more popular in Asia. Is it still worth it to look at this headset as an alternative to other 3DoF headsets out there? Let's find out. First, the Goblin 2 is a wireless 3DoF VR headset, meaning it can only track your head orientation and you can only roll, yaw, and pitch. This is like the Oculus Go, whereas the more high-end headsets like Oculus Rift and HTC Vive are 6 degrees of freedom, which makes it possible to naturally walk around in a virtual environment. Be aware that we are checking out the G2 Pro, which has a gray body, whereas the standard G2 model has a white body. The technical specs are almost the same, except the G2 Pro has double D onboard storage and the RGB camera for pass-through views. The display and all the hardware inside the two models are exactly the same. While you are watching this, let us know down below what you think of the Pico G2's look. Do you find it sexy or not so much? Next, a quick run through of what's inside the box. The box contains the Goblin 2 Pro headset, a 3DoF controller, 2 AAA batteries are included for the controller, an USB-C charging cable, install guides, and a cleaning cloth for the sweaty ones among us. So, what are its technical specifications? We will compare the Goblin 2's technical specifications with the Oculus Go, since that is the most well-known 3DoF headset out there and the only 3DoF headset that we own. The Goblin 2 comes with a Qualcomm Snapdragon 835 CPU and 4GB RAM, and 2 Fresnel lenses with a combined resolution of 2880x1600, which is about 3K. The refresh rate of the display is 90Hz and the field of view is 101 degrees. The built-in storage for the Pro is 64GB and is upgradable to a maximum of 256GB with a microSD card slot. Next to this slot is the USB-C 3.0 port and an audio jack connector. There are also 2 buttons here. The right one is the on-off button. The left buttons are for the volume. At the bottom, there are 2 speakers pointing downwards. To the side, there are 3 more buttons. On button to exit an app, select button, and menu button. The battery is placed at the back of the headset's strap, which has a capacity of 3500, which should give about 3 hours of playtime. If you run out of the battery, you charge the device using the USB-C port. There's a monocular RGB camera in the front, only available on the G2 Pro. In the West, the G2 is only available for businesses at the moment. However, both models are available for consumers in China. I will link the Chinese shop down below. On these websites, the standard G2 headset is priced around $290. The Pro model is priced at around $560.
My first impressions of this headset is that it looks and feels elegant.
The front has a soft fabric layer on it, and I like the dark gray front with rounded corners. The rest of the body is made of strong polycarbonate. The face foam feels like high quality leather and is removable. The head strap is flexible and adjustable on the sides. You can remove this part if you want a wider fit from the top. The headset is comfortable to wear because the batteries at the back gives the headset more weight towards the back, making it less front heavy. I also find the gray color tints combination really beautiful, and I feel that this combination makes it one of the more elegant looking headsets.
So, what about its capabilities?
The first thing I noticed is that the screen quality of the G2 is very sharp and clear. There isn't much screen door effect, only a little bit of the usual glare. This is actually much like the Oculus Go, except it seems like the Go has more screen door effect. The screen on the G2 looks a bit more clear too. This is probably because of the higher refresh rate and higher resolution. However, the Pico menu does seem less optimized than the Oculus Home menu. The loading times while navigating in the software is slower. Talking to Pico about this, they have told us that they are not focused on software or content, they are more focused on making the hardware and they let other developers take care of the content. Unlike Oculus, who also create VR games and experiences themselves. Playing a game or watching a VR video is great and I don't notice much difference here except for the clearer image. The audio speakers could be better though, it points downwards and it makes audio sound further away, unlike the Oculus Go audio which goes directly into your ear, making it more 3D. The 3 DOF controller works well and tracks well, there is an extra button that you can use to exit apps. An interesting feature is the camera in the front which allows for pass-through views into your real life space and even hand gesture inputs for menu selections. Again, great news for developers because they are able to add more features in their apps for the headset, but as a VR user you can only use this feature if there is content available that utilizes it, which I haven't found yet. The camera is also only available on the Pro model. Another interesting feature is that you can directly stream what you see on the headset to any MirrorCast device. It works on Windows 10 using Connect 2, like you can see here. The first time setup itself was easy, you do not need a mobile app for this headset, so you can just turn on the headset and connect it to your Wi-Fi. Once connected, you're ready to use it straight away. The G2 runs on Android 8.1 and most of its settings are not blocked or limited, unlike in the Oculus Go, which uses Android 2. This is good news for any developer since you have more freedom to customize its software. As a developer, you might also be happy to know that the G2 utilizes the 5-way VR open platform, which makes it easier for content developers to create for various mobile VR headsets and accessories. As for content, Pico has a partnership with HTC Vive, which gives access to HTC's 5-port content platform. Pico also has their own content store, but there isn't much content available there. There are a little over 100 games and apps though, including some cool VR games like Wands. 5-port has some content too, but there isn't much to choose from. You do get about a dozen more apps if you use an account that's located in China.
So, to conclude this dive into VR video,
the Pico Goblin 2 is the most powerful lightweight VR headset at the moment. The specs are in many points better than the 3 degrees of freedom VR headsets out there at the moment. Compared to the Oculus Go, the G2 has better specs, but it is also about $90 more expensive if you go for the standard model. As a VR gamer, you might find that the headset lacks content. Oculus has the biggest library of VR games and apps right now for 3 DOF headsets. So it seems like the Pico Goblin 2 has a lot of advantages for a developer that can use the G2 to develop for VR or to showcase what they made. You have more out-of-the-box freedom with the software, but also more hardware options to do what you want. Things like expandable storage and a USB-C connection are welcoming, which also makes us wonder why the Oculus Go does not have this. So as a VR developer, this is the bang for the buck 3 DOF headset right now, but as a gamer, I would hold off for now. If you are entirely new to virtual reality, we would actually even suggest to hold off buying a 3 DOF headset until standalone 6 DOF headsets with 6 DOF controllers come into the market next year. Pico actually also has one called the Pico Neo. Depending on what the price tag is for these headsets, we feel that the standalone 6 DOF headsets will eventually take over.
So, what do you think of the Pico Goblin 2? Is it sexy or not so much? Let us know down below. I'm super curious to hear your thoughts as well. Thank you guys so much for watching this whole video. I hope you really enjoyed it. One special thanks goes to our patrons for being there for us. Thank you guys so much. And if you want to explore more VR with us, make sure to subscribe and hit that bell as well to get all the notifications. And well, we are Cass and Chary VR, and I am Cass, and we always say VR on!